Okay, so today I'm going to be talking about the kingdom of heaven. The kingdom of heaven is what Christians or anybody that believes in Jesus will inherit after this life. Okay, it's only God's holy people. Anybody can become God's holy people. They will inherit the kingdom of heaven after this life. And Jesus is the key to enter into this kingdom. So I'm just going to read Matthew 13:45 to 46, and it reads, "Again, the kingdom of heaven is like unto a merchant man seeking goodly pearls, who, when he had found one pearl of great price, went and sold all that he had and bought it." So, you know, in this verse, we know that in order to inherit the kingdom of heaven, we have to sell over all of our possessions in this life. You have to give up everything in this life to inherit this kingdom of heaven. Okay? It's not just enough to just confess that Jesus is your Lord and Savior, but you're gonna have to live for Jesus. Like, it's a sacrifice. Okay? You're gonna have to go through a lot of trials and tribulations. Okay? And a lot of the times you're going to have to stand alone, okay? Don't expect anybody to come and save you. You know, when things get hard, you're gonna have to stand alone. You know, God is your that's who you fall on when things get hard, is God. Okay? Yeah, so the Bible says that, you know, is it actually worth, you know, gaining the whole world to lose your soul, to lose your precious soul? Is it worth, you know, getting all the fame and fortune and luxury and riches just to lose your soul? Meaning, you're going to be damned to hell. You're going to hell after this life if you don't have Jesus Christ. Like I said, Jesus is the key to the kingdom of heaven. If you don't have him, you're going to a real everlasting hell. So is it worth having all this material stuff that's all temporary, right? We're all gonna die someday. This stuff is all temporary. Having all the material, having all the luxury, the riches, you know, being liked by the world. These are all temporary, you know. But, you know, to be with God forever, you know, that's obviously everlasting. So why would you wanna separate from God for eternity just to have temporary riches? It's not worth it at all. So please be wise and give your life to Jesus Christ. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. No one gets to God but only through Jesus Christ. Okay? Recently, there was one of the royals, Prince something. I think Prince, I don't know his name, but he's one of those royals, British royals, okay? He was a prince. He died recently at the age of 99, right? He had the whole world. He had everything, right? He was part of a royal lineage, right? But we can see that he's no longer here, okay? He died. We're all going to die someday. That's a real reality of this life. It's something that a lot of us do not want to think of. A lot of us don't think about, you know, on an everyday basis. We think that we have all the time, you know, in the world to live. But that's not the truth. You know, every day I turn on the news and I'm seeing people die, you know, tragically. I saw today that some police officer was shot and killed, you know, so tragically. You know, people getting into accidents every day. When I turn on my local news, this is what I'm hearing, you know. So it's like, you know, don't have that in mind that we have all the time in the world. Do not have this in mind, because anything can happen. So many tragedies happen on an everyday basis. But it's God that keeps us. Even if you don't believe in him, it's God that keeps us. It's God that's protecting us. Okay? So much is happening on an everyday basis. Just turn on your local news. Okay? You know, see what's happening on a national level. See what's happening overseas. It's okay. So many people are dying, you know, every day, you know, tragically, okay? When, you know, they least expect it, you know, it's like you don't see it coming. So that's just how it is. That's how death is. So please stop, please give your life to Jesus Christ, you know. Please give your life to him, because tomorrow is not promised. I know a lot of people do not want to hear this, but this is the true gospel. This is the true gospel that either, you know, you give your life to Jesus or you perish, okay? A lot of people don't want to hear this. They want to believe in prosperity gospels where, you know, God is just going to bless you with luxury and riches and, you know, if you serve him and pay your tithes, but that's not the truth. The truth is, you know, you have to sacrifice everything to live for Jesus, and we're not everybody's meant to be rich in this life. Not everyone is, okay? Most of us are not. You know, we're not meant to be rich. That's the honest truth. You know what I mean? And we do not have all the time in the world, okay? God can call us home anytime. Any time, you know? So, the message is to just please give your life to Jesus, you know? You know, I was getting a little bit emotional because I have this app on my phone, like I said, you know, where I'm able to check what's happening in my local area, and I'm seeing, you know, children dying, you know, as a result of, you know, gun violence, and kids, you know, these young kids, people just getting into all these tragedies, and that's why I'm getting so emotional, you know. That just shows you, like, that's the reality of this life, that none of us are special. Anything can happen to any one of us, you know, at any given time. So don't waste any time and give your life to Jesus. You know, that's the message. I don't mean to scare anybody or make anybody feel, you know, depressed or any of that, you know. But you just gotta give the truth, you know. We have to speak the truth. Whether people want to hear it or not. You know, the truth is things that we do not want to hear. A lot of us want to live in a lie. Okay, that's the world, you know, okay? Because a lot of us are too consumed with the worldly pleasures, right? The pleasures of the world, we're too consumed with it. We're living our lives in a lie. So, you know, we do not want to hear the truth. Okay, but Christians, we come to tell you the truth. Okay, we come to preach this gospel and tell you the truth, that stop being blinded by all the pleasures of the world and everything that's happening in this world, you know. Don't be too blinded by it, because because, you know, the reality is we're here for one reason, and that one reason is to serve God and to live for God. You know, that's the reason why God brings us here. A lot of people don't know this, but that's actually the true purpose of this life. Nothing else actually matters, okay? Nothing else matters. I know I'm going all over the place with this, but, you know, I'm just saying whatever comes to mind. But, you know, nothing else actually matters. You know, that's why we lose people in this life, people that we dearly love. I mean, we lose possessions in this life. We lose a lot of things because those things don't actually matter, okay? But we have to serve God, live for God, and God, you know, he's going to judge, you know, at the end of this life. He's going to judge us for what we did in this life. So please choose Jesus. He is the way, the truth, and the life. The only way to make it to heaven. So that's the message. So I'm going to end this right here. May God bless you.